The Quintin Chronicles. The Horse's Christmas Tree. It was a pretty and bright Christmas Eve day at the barn at the end of the lane. The horses were ready to take the reindeer's places and deliver presents while the reindeer rested. Quintin and Roscoe were out in the field waiting for Santa to come. They were looking at all the pretty houses on the lane. All were decorated that Christmas with bright lights and colorful decorations, except for one. "Quintin, why isn't that house decorated?" asked Roscoe. "I don't know," said Quintin. "That's where the soldier's mother lives. She always looks so sad. Maybe it's because she doesn't have decorations." They thought for a moment. Then Roscoe said, "Why don't we decorate the Christmas tree in the yard for her?" Quintin nodded in agreement, and they hurried back to the barn. They started looking for things to use to decorate the tree. Quintin got his carrots and apples. Roscoe found some sleigh bells, candy canes, and shiny horseshoes. Off they went to the lady's house. The horses started decorating the tree, and it was an unusual sight. People on the lane came out of their houses to see what was going on. Two horses decorating a tree was different to see. The lady of the house came out with her dog Bosco, and all she could say was, "Oh my!" The tree was very pretty with its decorations, but they needed something for the top of the tree. Bosco, the lady's dog, ran into the house, then came back, and in his mouth he had a cowboy hat. Quintin took the hat and put it on the top of the tree. The lady just smiled. The hat belonged to her son, who wouldn't be home that Christmas Eve. The neighbors all started coming over about then, and the lady told them how wonderful it was that she had a decorated tree. Her son would decorate for her each year, but this year he was away. Because he was a soldier, he wouldn't be home, but his hat would be there for her. The neighbors all went back to their houses and brought back more decorations for the lady's house. Some even brought cookies and cake, hot chocolate and cider. It was wonderful that she wouldn't be spending Christmas Eve alone. It became a Christmas Eve party, and everyone was having fun. Then the horses heard the sleigh bells in the distance. They remembered they had to get back to the barn. Santa was coming. They hurried back to the barn at the end of the lane. That night, when they flew with Santa, they circled the Christmas tree they had decorated for the soldier's mother three times. One time was for the soldier being brave to be a soldier. The second time was to give thanks for the soldiers protecting our country. And the third time was for the soldier to come home safely for next Christmas. All who saw the horse's Christmas tree with a cowboy hat at its top knew it was for a soldier protecting his country who would not be home that night except in their hearts. Merry Christmas.